Hey gamers, this one's gonna be a little spooky. I'm getting in early for Halloween, but don't worry everyone, I won't put in any jump scares. Maybe. Now, I'm no feline, but I'll admit it, I'm a pu55y, and I can't handle horror. And there's surely a surplus of horror games in circulation. And unlike movies, horror games have an unrivaled interactivity, only to that of actually getting chased by a murderer, which I'm sure is a relatable affair. Like for example, if you're watching a horror flick, your actions don't change the outcome of the movie. And not to say you can't get immersed in the movie, of course you can, but when you play a horror game, you take full responsibility for your actions. You remove the safety net of, oh, it's just a movie, and that makes the hard-hitting moments that more scary. And I don't even want to touch VR horror, my poor little heart would stop. So that's a topic for another day. What I want to talk about today is everything but that, from the skimmed horror to the full fat horror. To begin with, I want to say there's two main techniques for horror. There's the psychological slow burner that builds up over time, making pure fear out of nothing. And then there's the other form, which I hate. I'm sure you've got it. It's jump scares. Now, a very memorable moment for me was back in the early days of high school. One of my friends got a new game on his phone, and he wanted to show us. The game was Five Nights at Freddy's, and I'm sure you've all heard of it, but it was brand new to us at the time. We all crowded around his phone to watch him play it, and it was terrifying. And when we got jump scared, we'd all jump back in unison and scream like the little babies we were. Mummy, mummy, ah. And I'm gonna be real with you, I only ever watched someone play it because I was genuinely too scared to play it myself. And I've always had this flaw about me, jump scares just don't gel with me. And I truly salute anyone who can handle it, you know? Now, on the other end, games like Amnesia play off the primal fear of the unknown. It's exhilaratingly terrifying, the fear of being chased, hiding in a closet. Guess the blood particles moving through my system at very high rates. And a bit of a wild card, but dare I say, Minecraft fits into both categories. Ooh, spooky, I know. I'm sure we can all think of examples, like being jump scared by a creeper or the creepy fucking cave noises. Which is intentional game design, I'm sure. But I also dare to say fits into the psychological horror category. It's just something about starting a game and being alone, and the only humanoid creatures or undead are strange deformed village folk. Even the soundtrack is somber and pensive. I remember being shown this game by my cousin, and playing it back in the day. I used to play on peaceful, because I was scared of the monsters, but sometimes when I was in a cave, the ambient cave noises make my heart sink. And I've run out of the cave just like the little ocelot I was. That might just be me, but that was my silly experience anyway. Now, a game not focused on horror, but pulls it off amazing in my opinion, Dark Souls 3. The horror sections of this game take you by surprise, and have you hanging your sweaty arse on the edge of your seat. They use jump scares and psychological horror to lead you to make mistakes, and act irrationally through fear alone. And honestly, fuck Irithyll Dungeon. Ah, Irithyll Dungeon, my favourite place. Got some lovely scenery, walking through like a, I don't know, a dungeon I guess. Sure nothing bad can happen over here, eh? Oh. That's nice. Oh, he's still alive. Be wary of right. What could that put? Is that guy okay? I mean, you know. Hi, friend. Oh, careful, lads. Careful. No! Bro, stop farting, dude. This is only like the freaking first level. There's more to go, look. Hello? Man, I wonder what's freaking down here, dude. Oh! Oh, I fucked up. Oh my god, no. Man, Man, this place is cool. Man, that looks delicious. Cool. Fuck off. Fuck off. Fuck off. This ain't even the freaking lowest level yet. Jesus. Do you mind? Do you mind? Final bite. I ain't just giving up those souls. That is actually a lot of souls. No! Let me through. Aw, no. Yeah, okay, cool. Have learned from my mistakes, hey. This place looks cool, dude. I wonder if there's any loot in here, you know what I'm saying? Nope. Hi, guys. Oh, okay. Okay, alright. Okay, no. I'm not going in there. That guy had red eyes. Excuse me. That guy's freaking alive, dude. No kill like an overkill! Man, that guy looks a little bit... I don't know, a little bit discolored. That's kind of weird. Oh, well, at least I'm out of here with a little dungeon, eh? Oh! Okay. Well, there's my tour, minus the jump scares and such. You know, don't want to scare any of you or anything. That'd be silly. Man, I need to change my pants after that. That section of the game is a fucking nightmare. The success of horror relies on the adrenaline rush people get from getting jump scared and such, and I can vibe with the adrenaline part, but a deep primal instinct within me just screams profanities of every caliber, so that's why I shy away from stuff like this. I don't really know what I'm trying to say with this one, just sharing my experiences, and I do enjoy horror to a degree, but sometimes it skates on thin fucking ice. And I'll gladly take the title of pu55y, but if you ever ask me to play a horror game or go see a horror film, you better fucking hold my hand, because I need all the emotional support I can get. Anyway, that's the end. Not really played enough horror games to, you know, make an extensive speech or anything. I'm all pussy and stuff. Spooky, scary skeletons and shivers down your spine. Shrieking skulls will shock your soul. Sfigiati del destino scelto. Romani, solo il risultato, se vuoi sarete distrutti. L'eterna scima esiste solo per me. Puglio cantare canzoni di tristezza nel mondo senza tempo.
I'm fucking frying.